Pogba and not Vinicius, okay? So, again, good luck.
Oliveira in the blue and Gallo in the white. Italy versus Brazil. Round number one coming up.
And Gallo is a kicker. Watch the low kick. They come fast and they come in plenty.
I got to say, this is... Oh, good right hand right away by Oliveira. He's coming storming out.
That was a beautiful first shot to start the fight. Right on the chin.
Oliveira jump-starting this thing early in round number one, catching Gallo sleeping a little bit at the early part of that. Oliveira with a knockdown!
I was about to say, Oliveira's a much better puncher than he is a kicker, and that's what Gallo's really got to watch out for.
Oliveira really seizing the opportunity here, because Gallo had predicted the knockout, but Oliveira is the one who's taking care of business.
Gallo's getting hit hard with that right hand.
When he said his nickname is Badass, he certainly meant it. And there's another knockdown.
Ho!
Two and one run. One more, Frank. This
one
fight
more,
is over.
It's over.
Yeah.
Oh, that's tough. He's got almost 2 minutes left. Nice angles by Oliveira, slipping out underneath that tie plumb and throwing good counter shots, first to the body and then the head.
It's the right hand of Oliveira that's done all the damage thus far here in round number one.
We talked about that right hand. He should bang it to the body, come up with the hook. He's really got Gallo hurt here.
Oliveira standing right in the pocket waiting for his opening, and he's got Gallo hurt again. Well, Gallo went right down onto his head.
Is that a head throw?
That was improvisation.
That was impressive. Leads with the right, Oliveira does, just right down the pipe. He's hitting Gallo every shot.
1 minute left in this first round, and Oliveira is going for the quick knockout. Head kick by Gallo. It was blocked, though.
He's one more knockdown. He can get out of here early.
Gallo has to be careful with his reserve tank. He's really trying to get that third knockdown.
Gallo looks just out of it. He's still throwing, though. Pops that straight right, followed by an inside leg kick.
Coming forward, I would have to say that Oliveira has to be very, very careful not to spend all of his gas here in round number one. 20 seconds left. It's been all Oliveira landing the right hand over and over again.
Oliveira's got to set up more than just that right hand. He can't just keep winging that right hand out there. Taking a look at the replay. I mean, all Oliveira here. Beautiful short right that shook the chin of Gallo. Dropped him right to the canvas. Oh, Oliveira, he's finding the range. He's letting his hands go. Gallo just does not have an answer for it right now, except for to cover up and kind of hide. He landed a little left, kind of glancing blow there. But all the power shots have been landed by Jonathan Oliveira, and they have been right on the chin of Gallo.
Oliveira really piercing through those stiff arm shields of Gallo to land that punch there, that straight right hand. And it caught Gallo so many times. 10-7 round across the board. If this fight should go the distance, it's going to be a huge deficit to overcome. You know, Gallo's got to get some knockdowns. Minimum.
And he's only got 2 more knockdowns in the entire fight.
Right, exactly. But he's got to score some knockdowns on Oliveira to make this competitive fight. Otherwise, he's going to lose this decision. See how much reserve Oliveira has after that blistering first round.
He did put a lot in it trying to get that knockout.
He did, because it was interesting when he went back to his corner, he was draping across the ropes, clearly showing signs of fatigue.
This is where Gallo wants to be, kicking at range, covering the kicks with punches. I think you're right, Steven. I think Oliveira blew his load. I think he's tired.
Yeah, he did. He threw so many punches, especially in that last minute or two.
Oh, beautiful inside leg kick. You know, tripped Oliveira right to his knees.
The body language is not looking good right now for Oliveira. Look, he's huffing and puffing. Oliveira's got to get a second wind here. Oliveira's going to probably go down if he doesn't get a second wind here. He's going to be a punching bag.
Well, we talked about this being the kicker versus the puncher, and the kicker's coming back.
Oliveira leaning forward with his hands on his knees, fatigued.
Oh. Outside kick, inside kick. It's 1-2.
This is a complete reversal of round number one, where Oliveira is now the punching bag. Gallo stalking forward. Oliveira not offering anything in the way of
offense. Kicks. Yeah, he's just waiting for that big right hand now. Got no jab to cover it. Gallo's really coming on now.
To be fair, this was a short notice fight for both gentlemen. Oliveira taking the low kicks right on the thigh, and that's going to really appreciate later in this fight.
Oh,
oh no.
Big old knee.
I think they're ruling it a low blow. It was right on the belt line.
It was close. It might have been a lucky break for Oliveira. He needed rest.
A big break for him. But Gallo will recover as well. Oliveira is so close to winning by stoppage in that first round. It slipped out of his hands. And now he's on the... Oh, there's that right hand by Oliveira.
Oh, that little bit of rest. Put some chi back in him. He's going.
Exactly.
When he was working angles, though, he was so much better with the striking. When Oliveira was tucking, turning the angle, so much better with the hands.
Oliveira really, really running on empty here. He's happy to have that clinch. We have a 3-second clinch rule here in Glory.
No hugging in Glory. You fight for Glory.
20 seconds left. Gallo really catching his second wind here while Oliveira is still fading. 10 seconds left. Gallo surely won this round. I would have to say we're getting into a situation where Gallo still needs to do some serious damage and get some knockdowns to get back into this fight.
Yeah, he definitely took that round, but he's still in a hole.
We're here at the Excel Arena in London, England, for Glory 5.
And Nicola Gala is feeling his oats now, really getting his kicking game on. Look at that inside kick. Just takes the legs out from Oliveira. He's doing a great job in chopping out the base of that puncher, because there'll be no more power in those hands or movement in those legs when Gallo's done with them. Just continuous, well-timed leg kicks. He's covering the kicks with punches, finishing with those chopping leg kicks that are just going to take the wheels up underneath Oliveira.
But for the most part, it seemed like Gallo didn't land that many significant punches.
Not too many, but he got good kicks on. Obviously, he run the round with a 10-9 point score, but I don't know. I think he needs some knockdowns or a knockout if he's going to finish this.
Yeah, because he's still behind by 2 points. Gallo probably should go to the body here.
Yeah, I think he bangs the body. Because Oliveira is just going to do that peekaboo stance and look for that big right hand.
Yeah, because Oliveira could probably last this thing out if he doesn't go to the Gallo doesn't go to the body. Gallo's going to the leg and the head.
Stay on the leg and hit that body.
And the head shots aren't that damaging.
Uh-oh, there we saw some instability in the legs of Oliveira.
Yep. It's a smart move to go for the clinch for Oliveira.
Oh, the Brazilian is just gassed.
That leg is going to be toast tomorrow.
He's still standing, though. Technically, he's still winning.
Gallo is throwing technical punches, but he needs to load up a little bit. Now, like that right hand, he landed a really clean right hand to Oliveira's jaw. It's the low kick, though, that is winning this round for Gallo. The body punches. Oh, that was directly.
That one was low.
Directly on the low area. Ouch. Second low blow of the fight for Oliveira. He doesn't take. There's another low blow. There's going to be a point taken away. And Gallo cannot afford that whatsoever. As a matter of fact, he's got to get a knockdown here. Otherwise, this is probably going to be, at minimum, a draw fight.
Halfway there. He's got a minute 30 left.
Yeah.
That inside leg kick is just tremendous.
I can see that Gallo is programmed to end his punch combinations with a knee or a kick. I think he should go flat-footed and go for punches.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more, Stephen. I just think all the fight is gone out of Oliveira. I just think he's in there trying to survive.
Yeah.
And I like that idea of a body shot, too. Rip that body up.
If Oliveira can do some damage here, because Gallo is leaving himself a little bit open, some opening for Oliveira, but Oliveira too tired to capitalize. There's Oliveira with an attempt to get things started. 45 seconds left here in round number three, which may or may not be the final round, because if it goes to a draw after three rounds, we will have a sudden death overtime fourth round.
And Gallo's corner should be yelling at him like crazy, because this is the time to make a finish. Go for a finish. Go for a knockdown.
He's got to dig to the body.
Yeah, rip that body. Hook the head.
But I'm telling you, that first round took it out of him. It really did, because you know, getting knocked down twice, that probably took away his punching power.
Oliveira's still got power in his punches. They're just far and few in between now.
Both men running on empty here at the end of round number three. Will it be a draw? Did Gallo do enough? Did the reserve that Oliveira built up early be enough?
Well, Gallo was brilliant with his knees, inside kicks. Here we saw Oliveira get a little bit shaky. I thought he might be going down, but I think his legs were just getting a little tired, getting a little chopped up. And look at the combination of punch, punch, inside kick, punch, punch, outside kick. Gallo, just what a beautiful combination of punching and kicking strikes. Oliveira came on very strong in the beginning, rocked him, dropped him, but totally gassed himself out and became a punching bag, where Gallo was just teeing off on him. Here's a beautiful short uppercut to the right.
What happens when you roll the dice like he did, meaning Oliveira, in that first round? We're going to find out now. Looks like we have a decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, our five judges have scored the bout with a total of 140 to 135 in favor of the winner. In the red corner, Jonathan Malopeiro Oliveira.
Wow. It was really close, Frank.
That was really close.
That could have been a draw round. Oliveira, man, he's going to learn from this. Actually, Gallo's going to learn as well. I see a rematch down the line for these gentlemen. They really brought it here.
I think there should be a rematch. That was a very well-matched fight. And yeah, I mean, it could have gone either way. You know, if he could have got Oliveira down, if he could have hurt him, knocked him down, it would have made the difference.
Yeah, Oliveira is going to sleep well tonight, though, because he was so, that second round, when he leaned forward and put his hands on his knees, like, wait.
That's when you know you're tired.
You know, it's like saying, can we have a timeout here? But unfortunately, there's no timeouts here in glory. Okay, that was a great fight. Oliveira takes it with a very, very close decision after three.